Good morning, brothers and sisters. We hope that you had a good week and are wearing your mask and social distancing. We do ask that you hit the subscribe button so that you will be notified when a new message is released. We thank you once again for tuning in to the Pastor.Faith YouTube channel. We try to bring you in-depth messages using the manuscripts which the King James Bible was originally interpreted from, to give everyone a deeper and clearer view of the Bible. The Bible is a book that was created with the wisdom of God to teach and not to confuse. In the book of James, chapter 1, verse 5 through 6, teaches us, "If any lack wisdom, let him ask of the Lord that giveth to all men liberally." So go with us now into another message, which are recorded at the home church live because of the COVID, and some come straight from the desk of the pastor. Come on and follow us with your Bibles. All right, we again thank God for all the many, many blessings that he does bestow upon us, and how he gives us all the necessary needs that we request him to take care of. Today, this lesson is entitled, "What is the Rapture? Is the rapture a lie or a misinterpretation?" So we can feel better about lives, future as a Christian. Now, there's quite a few scriptures here. I can't tell everybody what to do, but I can tell you when I was moving along in my infant years of learning the Bible, I wrote down every scripture because I knew that I was not going to remember it all. And I knew that I had to have a homework assignment to go behind whoever was speaking at that time to make sure their ducks were in a row. The idea of understanding the Bible is all about getting the scriptures in line properly, but not going about and making things up to cause contentment in the church. So as we look at Ezekiel 13:16 through 21, it reads, "To wit, the prophets of Israel, which prophesy concerning Jerusalem, and which see visions of peace for her, and there is no peace, saith the Lord God." So anybody that says peace, peace, peace is going to come, they're fakes, because God says that there is no peace. And definitely no peace for all of us that are walking with God, because there you have Satan's crew that are fighting against what we believe. And I don't know how many churches you've been to in a lifetime, but there's confrontations in churches about doctrine, about what's being said, what's being believed. And Satan's just feels right at home in the church when he can cause that kind of confrontation. And I say, thus saith the Lord God, woe to the women that sew pillows to all armholes and make kerchiefs upon the head of every statue to hunt souls. Now, this is making the untruth doctrines that is being preached to you all, to me all, comfortable to listen to and to make them believable. He goes on to say, "Will ye hunt the souls of my people, and will you save the souls alive that come unto you?" No, because these false prophets and pastors will hunt the souls for their own profit, not for God's gain, which is salvation. And will ye pollute me among my people? In other words, tell things that are not true, but are believable to those that don't know the scriptures. In other words, tell them false things about me. For handfuls of barley and for pieces of bread to slay the souls that should not die, and to save the souls alive that should not live, by your lying to my people that hear your lies. Wherefore, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I am against your pillars, your methods, in other words. Wherefore ye there hunt the souls to make them fly. Now this is believing in false doctrine. And he goes on to say, and this is Ezekiel getting the vision from God, and I will tear them from your arms. In other words, God is not done trying to win the souls back that have been stolen by the falsies. Those that want to hear the truth. And he goes on to say, and I will let the souls go, even the souls that ye hunt to make them fly. He wants them to know the truth, to understand the truth, that they may be in the spirit. Verse 21, your kerchiefs also will I tear and deliver my people out of your hands, and they shall be more in your hands to be hunted, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. Now, when you're talking about these pillows, these kerchiefs, we're talking about a comfortability to make people feel at home. And again, if you don't study the word, read the word, then you're not going to know the word, whether it's an error or not. John 8:32, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. The rapture is a document, or is a doctrine, used by Christian churches to explain what they think will happen when Jesus Christ returns to save the church from the punishment to the world called the Great Tribulations. Now, many of you may not know this or may not understand. I don't know how far studying you have done, but there was a woman named Margaret MacDonald. She was born in 1815 in Port Glasgow, Scotland, and died around 1840. She lived with her two older brothers, James and George, both of whom ran a shipping business, beginning in 1826 through 1829. A few preachers, along with Margaret MacDonald in Scotland, emphasized that the world's problems could only be addressed through the outbreak of supernatural gifts from the Holy Spirit. Which one breakthrough from her was the word rapture. We Christians will be carried away before the tribulation takes place. If we search the scriptures, we will find there is no such word in the Bible called rapture. Remember, presently we are living in the fifth trump. You got to understand the trumps, which is the time of teaching. We're living in the time of teaching. The sixth trump is the next trump to come, which is the return of Satan, the Antichrist. And in the Bible, we will find the word caught up, which happens at the seventh trump. In scripture, 1 Thessalonians 4:17, after that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. And that is spiritually, okay? Not physically, not with the body. This is spiritually. Bible translations into languages of English people can be traced back to the late 7th century, including the transactions into the Old and Middle English. Now, these were are more than 450 translations into the English, which have been written. Now, as we go and we look in Matthew chapter 24, and Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you. He doesn't want his people to be deceived. He wants us to understand the word and find clarity in it. For many shall come in my name, underline that, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. Study in 2 Timothy 2:15, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. What does this mean? This means you've studied, you have your I's dotted and your T's crossed, and no one's going to change you on what you believe. Matthew 24:6-15, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars, seeing that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdoms against kingdoms, and there shall be famines, pestilence, and earthquakes in divers places. And I really do believe that we are experiencing that now. So there can be no denial. All these are the beginnings of sorrow, Jesus says. Now, this is a bit different than what the false preachers and teachers were teaching back in the book of Ezekiel, pretty much on what we are hearing taught today. Talking about we're going to escape all this, we don't have to go through all of that. Well, I say this to any and everybody, what will you wake up feeling like when the sixth trump comes and the Antichrist is here working his devious powers, convincing people that he is the Christ and he's not? Now remember who he is. He's an imitator. He imitates everything about God. And if you're not uppity, uppity, up on your scriptures, you're going to fall in line and go, oh, he's the one that I've been waiting for. Come on, rapture me out. Verse 9, then shall they deliver you up into the to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. There's going to be a period during that time when we all are going to be, that are left on this earth, that are going to be tried and tested against what we believe. You're just not going to go on in life, well, I'm not going to believe him, I'm not going to believe he's here, I'm just going to put him behind me. Nope, you will be tested. Because remember, there's going to be a lot of things that are going to be at jeopardy. Your medicine, your medical, your food, and eventually he's going to change the currency, and it's going to be his currency, and you will have to obey if you want to continue to live the earthly fruits of life. And then shall many be offended and shall betray one another. Here we go, the fussing, the fighting, and shall hate one another. This is called spiritual divisions. And guess what? Race, guess what? Sex is not going to make a difference whatsoever. It's going to be about survival. But it's going to be all spiritually motivated. So if you're not spiritually inclined, if you're not into the word, there's many that's going to lose their souls. Because they're going to bow down, they're going to worship him, because they want to eat, they want money, they want medicine, they want to be comfortable like they were at one time. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. They're not going to love each other. They're not going to try to help each other. If anything, steal from one another and to get what they want. There's not going to be love shown. But he that shall endure unto the end, speaking about us, the Christians, the same shall be saved. Does that sound like we will escape the tribulation? No. And remember, this is Jesus talking. This is not the disciples bringing forth the word. They're writing what he says, but this is Jesus talking about the future. Now, this verse alone defeats the post and mid-tribulation rapture theory about taking away of the Christians from off the earth. We are going through until the end, unless God sees fit that our time on earth has expired, and then he removes us. Now, the rapture theory about the taking away of the Christians from off the earth, we are going through until the end, till his second coming, which is the seventh trump to be Christ's witness to the world. It's the seventh trump. And the Antichrist, Satan, he comes in the sixth trump. Now, please don't get mistaken here. I get questions all the time from people about, where do you think he's coming from? You think he's coming from Rome? Think he's coming from Britain? He's not. Remember, Satan was supernaturally created by God. And we're going to read and get into the word a little bit more, and it tells where he's at. He is in heaven in chains. Do you remember when he approached Jesus and Jesus said, "Get behind me, Satan"? That means you're behind me forever. I'm in heaven, you're behind me in chains. And guess who's behind him along with him? That is the demons that follow him. There's some demons that are already cast into darkness, but these demons are the ones that are still present that followed him. They are in chains of darkness with him. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all the nations, and then shall the end come. Okay? That's going to be the end. That's going to be the seventh trump. And when ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation, that's Satan going in and pretending to be God, spoken of by Daniel. It wasn't just spoken when Jesus was here. It was spoken and prophesied back in the Old Testament by Daniel the prophet. He says, "Stand in the holy place. Whosoever readeth, let him understand." What's he saying? He's saying, this is and this is and will be Satan's dream to be fulfilled, to set in Jerusalem God's favorite place on the earth and claim himself as God and Lord. Now, if you want to get a little deep with this, we can look at the fighting that's going on now in Palestine, the fighting that's going on in Jerusalem right now. They've just killed a bunch of people this week. They're looking for their God. They call him a lot of different names or whatever, and whatever. But you got to understand, when Satan returns as the Antichrist, he's going to be every god to every religion. And there's not going to be any definitive argument about who he is. You know why? Because he's going to minister to the people's needs as they want him to. As you've heard me say, he's going to put a chicken in everybody's pot. He's going to give bread and monies to whatever you need. Now, who's going to turn down a person that portrays to be God, except those of us that read the word and know different? In the book of Revelations, seven trumps are sounded. Everyone say seven trumps.
Seven
trumps. One at a time to cue apocalyptic events seen by John at Patmos. Revelations 1 through 9 in his vision. Revelations 1:1. The seven trumps are sounded by seven angels. And the events that follow are described in detail from Revelation chapter 8 through 11. Now, the sixth trump, the sixth vial, and the sixth seal. Now, for some of you that didn't understand where 666 comes from, that's talking about the events that are going to be coming. The sixth trump, the sixth vial, and the sixth seal. That's why it says it's the name of a man, 666, because it's the event. And when the tribulation actually starts, the mark of the beast of Satan, it will be. And there was war. Listen to this. Here we go. Are you ready? Your ears wide open. Revelations 12, 7 through 10. And this is Jesus giving the revelations to John as he's at Patmos. John, let me get deep with you here. John was there, but he left his body. Do you remember they took him there? They were sick and tired of him preaching about the gospel, preaching about Jesus. So they took him away to an island and left him on the island by himself. Could you handle that? These people running around talking about, I'm a prophet, I can do this, I can do that. Really? Would you? Let me take you out on an island somewhere where there's nobody, nothing at all, and see how well you fare. Revelations 12, 7 through 10. And there was war in heaven. Everyone say war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought with his angels and prevailed not. He didn't make it. Neither was there a place found anymore in heaven. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world, not part of the world. And I want you to get a good understanding of this when it says he deceived the whole world. Listen to this and listen closely. His supernatural body was hanging there in chains. The chains of darkness, okay? I want you to understand this. Now, his body compassed his spirit compassed the earth, just like Jesus' spirit does right now. A car battery is made up of what? Positives and negatives. The same way that Jesus compasses this earth with his spirit, when we pray to him, he comes, he gives us an answer. The same way Satan's spirit compasses his earth. Why? It's to give each man and each woman an opportunity to choose. Because in the first earth age, it was perfect. There was no evil, there was no unrighteousness, none at all. And when Satan went bad, evil was revealed to everybody. And God, being the loving God that he is, he says, I can't let my children be lost. So he allowed the second earth age to be created, and men and women, well, at that time we were all in angel form. We were born by women into this earth. Now we know good and evil. Now we have to make choices every day. And that's what this was all about, making choices every day by Satan's spirit compassing the earth, by Jesus compassing the earth. So what are you doing? You're hearing good and evil, good and evil, good and evil. What are you going to choose? And the great dragon was cast out, and the old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world, he was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ. for the accuser of our brethren is cast down. That's Satan, cast down. He's kicked out of heaven, which accused them before God day and night. You want to know what Satan's doing day and night? He's accusing us before God. They're no good. They're not going to make it. Why are you wasting your time on them? That mouth is going like this. Satan's mouth is going like this. This is called real confrontation. So say that with me. Real confrontation. You know, sometimes we live our life down here on earth like there's nothing else going on. There's a lot going on up there. A lot. As we look at Revelation 11, 15, at the end of the tribulation period, and the seventh angel sounded, and there were great voices in heaven saying, the kingdom of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord. That's at the seventh trump, and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. Now, there are seven trumpets in the Bible, and trumpets always indicate a message. Everyone say message. But this trumpet is never called the last trump in the Bible, but it is the last trump spoken of. And again, it's blown in heaven, not on earth. As we look at Matthew 24, 30 through 31, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in clothes in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. That's the real Christ. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of the heaven to the other. And as we look at 1 Thessalonians 4:15 through 17, for this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. What are they talking about? We're not going to prevent them that are asleep, that we know that are not here, because their spirit has left and come with God and is with God and is coming back. Any one of your relatives, if you're still here, that have left, they're coming back. They're not in the ground. The body's in the ground, but they're not in the ground. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Why are they rising first? Because they're already going back with him, and they're coming with him back to this earth. The risen ones are ready with him in spirit, already risen from the earthly body. And when they died on earth, they that are coming with him, they're coming in spirit. Verse 17, then we which are alive and remain in spirit shall be called up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Now, this is the seventh trump, the last trump, not the sixth one. We are living in the fifth trump presently. As we look at 2 Peter 3:10, and I just want to make something clear to you. When you read scriptures, scriptures correlate with each other. And you got to find them and put them together. God did not write one passage through one man or woman and say, this is it, this is it. No, there's confirmation throughout the Bible of that scripture, which says hallelujah, which says amen. As we look in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 10, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Now, it's not talking about physically burned up, but it's talking about being cleansed. It's cleansed. because we are going to, the kingdom of God is coming back down on this earth, but it's going to be cleansed of every foul, despicable thing that man has done to this earth. It's going to be cleansed. In closing, this is Jesus speaking. Revelations 2:2. I know thy works and thy labor and thy patience, and how thou canst not bear them which are evil. And thou hast tried them which say they are apostles and are not, and hast found them liars. If they don't believe the word of God, and you know the word of God to be the word of God, then they fall into this category. Walk away, shake the dust off your feet, do not return, don't waste your time with them. Amen. Father, today we honor you, we thank you for your word, which continues to reveal itself to us. If we want to hear it, if we want to listen to it, if we want to be present before it. And we just ask you to open our minds, our hearts, our souls to receive it and meditate on it, that you will receive the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for joining us on the Pastor.Faith YouTube channel. We encourage you to have a conversation with God on a daily basis. Not many people take the time out of their schedule to do so. This ministry encourages everyone to receive Jesus Christ into their life as Lord and Savior. You may ask, how do I receive him? Just talk to him, confessing to him as being a sinner and how much you need his help. Asking Jesus into your heart, which is your mind, and in doing so, we then have a covenant with God that when we repent and ask for forgiveness for any of our sins, any time of the day, any hour of the day that we all commit regularly, God is justified to forgive us of our sins. Let me say, the most challenging moment through this process you will face is receiving that forgiveness. You may not feel comfortable the first time around, but practice makes perfect. Feel free to forgive yourself, knowing that someone loves you deeply as God Almighty. He himself has proven it all by bringing his only begotten Son to take on all our sins as the last sacrifice for mankind, to absorb all of the sins of mankind that we all commit, and still having the power to forgive us. We love you and look forward to meeting you and sharing the next message. Hey, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to be notified when the next message is released and posted. God bless you. Till next time. This holy man.
Bless his holy, bless his holy, his wonderful, wonderful name. He's brought us from a long, long way. Bless his holy name.